After yesterday's game, Arsenal are chasing in for a player who scored against them in the 74th minute in a corner that saw the goalkeeper of Arsenal, Aaron Ramsdale, obstructed by a player of a team which goes by the name of Aston Villa, and that is Douglas Luiz. Arsenal have made a 20 million bid for Douglas Luiz, and they are moving rapidly to sign him to come in and really save them and save their midfield area in there for you. And maybe Sambi Lokonga having a very good game against a team which goes by the name of Aston Villa, but they really believe that they need another midfielder. What if he also gets an injury? What will they do? That's why they are running fast for a player who goes by the names of Douglas Luiz. And then we're talking Hector Bellerin, shocking move to Barcelona, obviously rejecting Villarreal, reuniting with Unai Emery, his former coach at Arsenal, and obviously Ainsley Maitland-Niles to Southampton. It's a here we go, as confirmed by Fabrizio Romano. In this episode, we are having reports from Sky Sports, we are having reconfirmations from Fabrizio Romano and confirmations from David Obstein and very many others that are really reliable journalists. I go by the names of Rock and David. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Depends on where you're watching us from. Smash the like button, guys, and subscribe to this channel. Remember, we are left with like 300 subscribers to hit 7,000 subscribers. Let's make it happen, guys. Let's make it happen, mates. Let's make it happen, mates. And obviously, make me grow. Let us grow this channel together. Obviously, let's get into the first story of the day coming in from a man who goes by the name of Miguel Delany. No sooner had the game of Arsenal versus Aston Villa came to a halt, obviously, the story came out that Arsenal are looking for a midfielder potentially just as a short-term option. They'll investigate a deal for Douglas Luiz and are still talking to Palmeiras over a move for Danilo. The latter, however, currently looks likelier for January in the for you. Obviously, we've been told that a team which goes by Palmeiras are ready to sell Danilo in January, but they're not willing to sell him in this summer. So Arsenal have shifted from what they had planned before, £25 million bid turned down by side which goes by names of Palmeiras for Danilo. And obviously Arsenal look like they've turned their attack onto Aston Villa's central defense midfielder Douglas Luiz, who is left with 1 year on his contract and is not willing to go in and really renew it. That is a man who goes by names of Douglas Luiz, at a side which goes by names of Arsenal. Now today morning, Sky Sports really told us the following, that they broke this story that Sky Sports this morning, Atletico Madrid, Chelsea and Arsenal and Liverpool have all been tracking Douglas Luiz, and one club are set to make an official offer of £20 million today. So it looks like Liverpool, Atletico Madrid, Arsenal and everyone has been really making a chase for a player who goes by names of Douglas Luiz, and obviously it's never too late. And obviously the news is here that a bid has gone in, and I'm going to let you know which team has put in a bid of £20 million. That's why you should subscribe to this channel, because we come in with nothing other than facts. Fabrizio Romano coming out and letting us know that Arsenal are really trying to sign Douglas Luiz from Aston Villa. The player is understood to be keen on the move, however it's up to both clubs in there for you. So when you look at this deal, why is Arsenal going in for this deal? Because they want a CDM. Arsenal really having El Nini injured, Thomas Partey injured, and Sambi Lokonga, who is the only fit player, might also get an injury. Then what will Arsenal be left with? Will be left with nothing. That's why Mikel Arteta and Edu are pushing so much to sign in players, a player like Douglas Luiz. And you know, Douglas Luiz is Brazilian. When you look at the Brazilian environment at Arsenal, there are very many Brazilian players at Arsenal right now. There is Gabriel Magalhães, there is Gabriel Jesus, there is Martinelli, there is Marquinhos, who else? Martinelli, Gabriel Jesus, those four. And now if Atoli comes in, those are going to be five. And yesterday, there is a photo I want to show you to show that it was like Mr. Gabriel Jesus, who scored yesterday, was really trying to do the agent role at Emirates. Have a look at this, guys. Do you know that even with Yuri Tiedemans, when Arsenal was playing Leicester City, he was seen talking to Yuri Tiedemans He was seen talking to your team as like that, and was holding his, he was holding his mouth. You get? So why is he holding his mouth if at all they don't want to reveal what they are really saying to talking to one another? Because the moment you don't really cover your mouth when you are saying something, it's going to be outside there and it's going to be read, because you have people who interpret what you've been saying. Otherwise, they've not heard what you've been saying, but they can interpret it. So he has been told, he was talking to Douglas Luiz as you see him onto the pitch. And obviously, Douglas Luiz is now linked to Arsenal. And I'm asking myself, how do these things coincide together? Before the game, it was all about Danilo. It was not all about Douglas Luiz. But after the game, Jesus talks to the player who goes by the names of Douglas Luiz. And obviously, after 1 hour, a story of Douglas Luiz being linked to Arsenal really breaks the internet. And obviously, it's breaking the internet even up to now. And it's what we are talking about in here onto the Rokani Media Football. So, was it planned? You get? Because these players can influence other players to come in through, especially on the field of play, and really join the teams. So, let's see what is going to be all about a team which goes by the names of Douglas Luiz and Arsenal. So, after that, even David Austin has gone ahead to confirm this deal. It shows you that this deal is really in high gear that is going to happen. He has told us that Arsenal making offer for Aston Villa midfielder Douglas Luiz. Aston Villa adamant, 24-year Brazil international, not for sale, but it's understood he wants to leave, exploring if it's possible before deadline day. There is no way Aston Villa can really stop this deal to happen. Reason being, the player is left with 1 year on his contract. How can they be let stop him to go? Because if at all they say he's going nowhere, then he's going out on a free. That's it. So they have to sell him. And I think that is going to be another headliner in here onto this channel in the free. Now, the big and huge story of the day coming in from Cruz, coming in from TalkSport, Alex Crook of TalkSport, telling us that Arsenal have made an opening bid of £20 million plus add-ons for Aston Villa midfielder Douglas Luiz. This is the big story that I felt like I shouldn't go anywhere or start my day without presenting this to you, especially Arsenal fans all over the world watching in this channel, Rokani Media Football. Now, Arsenal have put in a bid of £20 million. £20 million for this guy, and obviously it looks like it's the offer that they had made to Palmeiras for Danilo being turned to signing another Brazilian who is already a Premier League proven player who goes by the names of Douglas Luiz. And Arsenal are really desperate to get him in. And I really believe that for Arsenal to sign Douglas Luiz, it's really going to be uneasy. It's going to be as easy as knife passing through butter. Do you know why? When you sign Douglas Luiz, he already possesses a visa and a work permit for the UK. So it's a matter of him crossing from Villa to Arsenal, and then everything is going to be done. And I think by Friday noon, tomorrow, he's going to be registered as an Arsenal player. And obviously, he'll come and play into that midfield when Arsenal is playing Manchester United. Obviously, Douglas Luiz is a good addition. I would love him at my team. Douglas Luiz, because he's better than Scott McTominay and Freddie, according to me. And secondly, if you are Douglas Luiz, you can't say no to this deal. Do you know why? The World Cup is near the corner. Tite, the coach of Brazil, the national team coach of Brazil, will really consider you as one of the best players when you're playing for Arsenal. That's it. And Douglas Luiz is a very good addition. He's a very good addition to that midfield area of Arsenal because it has been lacking a lot. After Thomas Partey getting an injury, Arsenal really has loopholes. But Douglas Luiz really comes in and really plays that single pivot well and really gives you the minerals that are required to go on and lay that part of the pitch trail in the for you. So that is a man who goes by the names of Douglas Luiz joining a side which goes by the names of Arsenal. And yesterday, Steven Gerrard was really asked about this gentleman. Steven Gerrard on Douglas Luiz's future last night said, "I'm not in control of that. That will be Douglas, his agent, and what happens around that. It is one of those really touchy situations where the club has to do what is the best for the club. So looks like he has given in. He has given in, according to what he's saying, that they are not in control of the deal and Douglas Luiz is the man responsible for his where next he's going to be playing. Now, this is a confirmation from Sammy McBall, chief football reporter for Daily Mail. He has told us that Aston Villa are close to an agreement with Wolves for midfielder Leander Dionka. Should they complete the deal, it would open the doors for Douglas Luiz to join Arsenal today. So, obviously, this is a confirmation that Arsenal is going to sign Douglas Luiz. And Aston Villa are willing to take the £20 million bid from Arsenal. But as a competent club, you have to first go in and really bring in a replacement first. That's it. So, they've gone to bring a replacement first, and then they want to go all out for a player who goes by the names of Leander Dionka from Wolverhampton Wanderers. So it looks like they've already admitted the player is not going to be here, and that's why they've gone in for a replacement, and Douglas Luiz might be an Arsenal player by the end of today. So that's what we've gotten from a side which goes by the names of Sammy McBell from Daily Mail in here on Tirokani Media. So let's wait and see how the deal of Douglas Luiz is going to really go on and really prosper at the end of the window. But we are here to bring you all the news and information. Now, after that, let me take you to another player of Arsenal. Rio Betis are no longer in the running to sign Hector Bellerin. Barcelona will decide today whether to sign him. However, he could stay at Arsenal too. That is Charles Schwartz. Rio Betis has really mugged off Hector Bellerin. Hector Bellerin turned down moves from Villarreal. You get Juventus, Atletico Madrid. Which other team? You get? And the only option he has left with on table was Real Betis and Barcelona, and was willing to turn against Barcelona for Real Betis. But Real Betis has finally pulled out. And obviously, the only team left is Barcelona. And now we've been told by Relevo, who goes on, let me flash it on your screen, on a bigger platform, all right? I think you see it very well there. We've been told by Hugo Cerezo and Relevo, they've told us that Barcelona have chosen to sign Hector Bellerin. They are in advanced talks with the player about a return. Bellerin will terminate his contract at Arsenal and would join Barcelona with a significant salary reduction. That is what Hector Bellerin has come out and really said and made a decision to join a side which goes by the names of Barcelona. So after that, the confirmation to this has been given to us by Dimazio. And Dimazio has told us that... Dimazio has told us that Hector Bellerin is close to joining Barcelona. Remember, Arsenal got Hector Bellerin and signed him from the La Masia Academy of Barcelona way back, and saw Arsene Wenger give him the senior debut of Arsenal, I think was at the age of 18. Yeah, and has been Arsenal for very many years, and obviously Arsenal are now willing to sell him. But he had turned down very many offers, and very many teams were willing to pay for him, but obviously it didn't happen. But today it looks like it's one of those deals that are going to happen, because Xavi, the manager of Barcelona, is really not interested in Sergino Dest. And Sergino Dest has already moved on to AC Milan on a long season loan with an option to buy. You get to sign a 4-year deal at AC Milan, meaning that he needs a right back. After Azpilicueta turned heel on Barcelona and stayed at Chelsea, obviously, when you look at Real Betis, when you look at Barcelona, they are lacking quality and depth onto that right back position. Reason being, before Jules Koundé was registered, they are playing with Araujo and Sergio Roberto. Now, in the game they won over the weekend by 4-0, Barcelona went ahead to play their new signing, Jules Koundé, who is supposed to be playing as a central defender. They played him as a right back. That's it. So it shows you how they are lacking options onto that right back position. So they are in for Hector Bellerin. I really believe there is a player in Hector Bellerin, and going at Barcelona might really flash him back to the world. 27 years of age, I think there is a player who is really good and talented in the face. So Dimazio has confirmed to us that Arsenal Arsenal's Hector Bellerin is close to joining Barcelona. Let's wait and see what is going to happen for this deal. And lastly, the man, Maitland Niles, finally has gone to a side which goes by names of Southampton, as confirmed to us by Fabrizio Romano. Flashing it on your screen as you see, read with me. Ainsley Maitland-Niles completed his move to Southampton, medical done and contracts to be signed now with Arsenal. New deal until June 2024 with Arsenal, and then loan to Southampton with buy option clause. So, this is a man who goes by the names of Ainsley Maitland-Niles. Before leaving Arsenal, he had to first trigger that 1 year extension that he had on his contract until 2024. Then he has signed a loan deal with Southampton that is going to see him be at Southampton for 1 year, and then sign another long-term deal with a team which goes by the name of Southampton. Ainsley Maitland-Niles, a player that I really believe he's talented, but I don't know whether Ralf Hasenhüttl will really get a good footballing career out of him. But let's wait and see, because he's a very talented manager, and when he scouts you, just know he has really noticed the talent in you. So guys, thank you very much for watching in. I don't know what you are really telling me about Douglas Luiz, 20 million bid submitted in by Arsenal to Aston Villa, then Hector Bellerin close to joining Barcelona, and Ainsley Maitland-Niles has obviously crossed from Arsenal to a side which goes by them Southampton in the for you. So let's wait and see who else is Arsenal going in for on this deadline day. According to the news coming in from the reliable sources, we are waiting to see who else is Arsenal chasing for, and we are here to do this as soon as possible. Today we are going to be more active, recording more videos, and Arthur Melo, formerly linked to Arsenal, going to Liverpool. So all those are really coming in through in here onto the Rokani Media Football. May the Almighty God bless you abundantly, and I protect you all in the blood of Jesus Christ. And guys, subscribe to this channel. We are less by 300 subscribers to hit 7,000 subscribers. Let's show and throw in the love in here onto Rokani Media Football. Rokan David is my name. I sign out for now. See you later. But don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Rokani Media Football. Search for us. Not every story is going to be put up here on YouTube, because lots of stories are really coming in through. So I really believe that we can go in and really take this not for granted. But before I sign out, if Douglas Luiz crosses from Arsenal to a side which goes by the names of crosses from Aston Villa to Arsenal, this photo will always be remembered, and that is agent Gabriel Jesus. What a way to have in a player like him. A player who is good on the field of play and puts in a 10 out of 10 performance every game. And he comes out even to persuade other players to come to play for the club. What a player. What a player at Arsenal, guys. Most of you didn't know that he was good at this, but he's good at this. He's one of the assistant captains after Martin Odegaard at Arsenal. He's doing a very incredible job at Arsenal. That is a man who goes by the name of Gabriel Jesus, and I think you are loving what he's doing. Yesterday, he scored his third goal in the 5th game of Arsenal. Remember, he has 5 goal involvements with 2 assists, and I think he has 3 assists. Oh, I even forgotten that one he did for Odegaard against Bournemouth. He has 6 goal involvements. You get 3 goals and 3 assists. That's what you get from Gabriel Jesus as a player. And he's trying to convince a man who goes by the names of Douglas Luiz to join Arsenal. And obviously, he did the same thing for Youri Tielemans, if at all you remember very, very well. Guys, first story of the day. More is yet to come. Smash the like button 1,000 times and endeavor to go into the lower right bottom corner and subscribe to this channel. After subscribing, hit the notification bell. That will enable you to get notified each and every time I upload a video into this channel. I sign out for now. See you later, my mates.